Good evening. Today is Thursday, April 27, 2017. This is Matt Davidson, Neerani Patel, with an adaptation of your VHS morning announcements. Please be advised that there is no smoking allowed in any school building or on school property in accordance with Chapter 71, Section 37H of the Massachusetts General Laws. In the unlikely event of an emergency, the exits are located to my right, left, in the back of the auditorium where you entered, and up the stairs to the left and right. Please leave the auditorium in an orderly fashion and proceed out the cafeteria doors to the parking lot. I would ask you to rise for the Pledge of Allegiance, but I know that half of you are trying to use this time to copy the homework from the person next to you, so I won't bother.
Happy birthday today to you. Add Rihanna, Zara Nike, and three other names that I will butcher, so I'm just going to not say them.
Bible study. We'll have a meeting on Tuesday, May 2nd at 7 a.m. in room 318, because some of you definitely need God if you're willing to be a school that early.
Tuesday, May 2nd is the professional release day. Students will eat lunch and then will be dismissed. As if letting us a whole 2 hours earlier will do any good.
Tomorrow will be an advisory day. Teachers should plan on bribing their students with donuts and coffee because that is your best chance of getting them to actually have a conversation.
Only those students who have permission from the school nurse are to use the elevator. Please remember that being too lazy to walk up 2 flights of stairs isn't a valid excuse.
There will be a senior show meeting in the library after school tomorrow at 2:15. Please come and contribute to the show because we don't want the same 15 people doing all the work.
VHS now has an official Twitter site. Please follow at BTownHS142 to obtain all the latest information about VHS and so administration can follow you and see who has that party last weekend.
This week is National Assistant Principals Week. Special thanks to Mr. DePonde for throwing away our document in the morning.
A reminder that AP tests are next week. Please remember that you paid $92 to not read that book. And you were just pretending to understand if you don't.
Final exams for seniors are May 22nd through May 26th. Like any of you, even plan on remotely understanding what your teachers taught you during fourth quarter.
There will be a school committee meeting next Tuesday at 7 p.m. Please show up to make sure to see what else they take away from us.
We wish we could waste some of your time so you don't have to take that physics test that you didn't study for, but I think that's all that we have for announcements today. My name is Matt Davidson.
And this is
Neerani
Patel.
And we hope that you have a great time at the senior show.
Welcome to the senior show.
Okay. What's up, Murray?
Hey, what's up, Bays?
Yo, can I get a six?
Absolutely, all you.
Sit! Alright, go.
Take it easy.
I can't wait for my healthy lunch tomorrow. It's 7:40! Found you. Oh, man. I'm late. You got that right? What am I doing?
Helping it.
Is my pencil right here? My pens? I think I have everything I need. Oh, dang, it's used. Oh well. Hey, guess what? We have to get involved in humanities. They do the blood drive, they bring toys to kids. It sounds so fun. I love community service. Yes, we're doing it. Okay, see you tomorrow.
Counting ballots for the class election? I don't think so. Oh, I'm so tired.
Hey, Miss Level. I checked on Power School and I have an 89 and it's like keeping me off honors, like high honors. And I've never been off high honors. Like, can I please, I'll literally write a paper or something, I'll do homework or, something, please.
Okay, just calm down. Just do that one homework assignment that you missed when you were out, and I'll boost the grade right up for you, no problem.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
I'm failing this class right now.
I just checked on Power School, and it's a 64, I need a 64.
Well, yeah, it's because
of... No, I tried hard. I really did. And it's... I need a better grade, and I don't understand why.
Arani, let me explain. You got below 20 on the past two tests. They've been an average of below 20 for both of them.
Yeah, but
Arani, we only had two tests. All quarter, we only had two.
Okay, but Ms. Rose, I tried.
Okay, well, hold on. Let me see what I can do. So, how about you do some of those 24, 25 missing homework assignments that you didn't do this quarter, and then maybe we can talk.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh. Okay, I'm gonna do something.
All right, get right on it.
Senior Ice really got the best of me, not gonna lie, it was kind of rough. If it wasn't due to the nagging among my teachers and my friends, I probably would have failed off. We've got to show some support for our faculty here, because of that.
Teacher,
what's that?
It's students against disruptive.
We literally, the weakest kid. because of that, we have students attending top universities like Dartmouth College, Northeastern, Tufts, and plenty of other schools.
Can we have a round of applause for that?
Let's see. Yeah.
Where are they up to anyway?
I don't know. Let's see. Let's see.
These are up to 200.
They are very interesting. Like, but I love them. Though. Gotta love them. Okay, honestly, guys, I just have to take up some time. So, I've been practicing lately, and I think I'm ready. I've been playing a lot of rock band lately, so you know, it's real. I'm a little nervous, though. Just a small town girl living in a lonely world. She took the midnight train going anywhere. Just a city boy from the South Shore. He took the midnight train going anywhere.
It's true. No, Donald, I was invited here to speak.
Run.
Donald, you're embarrassing.
See, folks, total lightweight. Typical politician, all talk, no action. And for that, Sarah, you're fired. Now, folks, our next act is absolutely fantastic. It features a dance to the song, Womanizer. Now, don't everybody look at me. I can assure you, these girls won't be fired. Please welcome to the stage, Jenna Brown, Alexa Brown, and Allison Robleski. Thank you.
Demonstrate.
take some notes. He's just awful. Yeah. So, watch.
Take a look for yourself. Or don't. It's not worth it. I mean, pretty bad spelling.
Hello, everyone. Quiet down. Shh. Everyone, please be quiet. That would be great. It is my pleasure to welcome you all to belchertown High School's first spelling bee. I think we're just going to get started right now. Well, the bell is about to ring, so I think she better come. My name is Dr. Mead, and these are your contestants. Introduce yourselves, please.
Hi, my name is Matt Davidson, and my favorite thing about Dr. Mead is probably that I can always count on him for his favorite geeky t-shirt on Thursdays.
My name is Jenna Blaine, and my favorite thing about Dr. Mead is his overuse of the word arbitrary. He's really brought up my vocabulary. My name is Haley Simon, and my favorite thing about Dr. Mead probably is his pirate puns and zombie t-shirts. My favorite thing about Dr. Mead is everything.
All right, now, could you please be quiet? I will be judging today. Are you all familiar with the rules? It's pretty intuitive. I think you'll get it. All right, Matt, why don't you start us off? Your first word is inertia.
Okay. Inertia. I'm gonna go with I-N-E-R-T-I-A. Inertia.
No! It's actually I-N-U-R-S-I-A. Inertia.
I'm pretty sure it's not that.
Okay, Jennifer, you're up next. Jennifer, right?
No, it's Jen, I sit in the front row.
Okay, Jennifer. Your word, is, a log.
A log. A-L-O-N-G. A log.
No! It's actually A. Well, that's how they taught it to us at the European Organization for Nuclear Research in Switzerland. So, Riley, you're up.
No, it's fine. I'm used to it at this point.
Riley, your word is vertical. No, that's not quite right. That one's pretty counterintuitive. I think you'll get it in time. It's actually V-E-R-T-I-C-L-E. Vertical. Okay, Kristen, you're up next. Your word, is, bat. I hit the ball with a bat.
B-A-T-T.
That is correct. We have a winner. Thank you so much for joining us today.
But we disappoint him all the time. Like, I'm never ever smart in his class. I am inferior to his 5'4 complexion.
He's definitely disappointed in his students.
Hey,
you know, it's not a baby shirt for donation.
Wait.
But you're wearing
it. This one?
Yeah,
I'm
not sure. No, teacher. Teacher.
No,
teacher. No, teacher. Hey, this is my clothes.
Get off!
To need two knee replacements by the crisp age of 25.
We're in Cahuilli.
Lastly, most likely to bring up their high school football stats in conversation.
Jacob Wendell.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Hastings, for only recognizing Kayla, Kara, Boy Soccer,
Superintendent Coughlin for canceling school when it rains out, not when there's 2 feet of snow outside.
Thank you, Ms. Waldron, for putting us to sleep when you shut off the light and read poetry in your NPR voice.
Thank you to the boys for being the ones to peek in high school so everyone else doesn't have to.
Thank you to you boys who are dating freshman girls for teaching us that age is just a number.
Thank you, Cameron Wright, for never studying, for trying on tests, and doing better than all of us.
Thank you to the HS Legacy for having an entire assembly to talk about student ideas and then implementing none of them.
Thank you, Dylan Spelsey, for making me fear for my life when you drive through the senior lot. Thank you, Ms. Tripp, for making me feel horrible about myself because your pregnancy body is better than my teenage body. Thank you, class of 2017, for never showing up to our meetings and then complaining that we never have meetings.
Thank you to the editors who always made sure that I edit.
Thank you all for coming. Unfortunately, there are no refunds.
No, we're serious.
No. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Haley, and welcome to Belchertown High School, home of the Orioles. For the past 4 years, Matt Davidson has been the class of 2017 class president, and today we're going to be talking to students, teachers, and Matt himself to get their opinions on how they think he's done. What are your thoughts on the senior trip?
Well, the officers and I worked really hard on trying to get together a senior trip. So we did one in the fall at High Meadows, which I thought people really enjoyed. And they enjoyed it so much that we wanted to do a second one. And we tried really hard. We put together a survey, and there was really no majority. We still went through with it and tried to plan one to Boston. And then Ms. Mino told us no. So I think we really put in a lot of work. It just didn't go through.
Let's hear what Ashley has to say about that.
The one thing I've been looking forward to throughout my entire high school career has been the senior trip, and Matt couldn't give that to us.
What are your thoughts on the senior skip day?
The nature of the class is that everyone's going to be busy at different times of the year. In the fall, people have sports, in the spring, people have sports. So we tried really hard to organize something in the fall, got maybe half of the grade doing it. In the spring, we tried to do another one. There was some drama, but I think we ended up figuring it out in the end.
Let's hear from the students. Did we even have a senior skip day?
It is absolutely ridiculous that we do not have a senior skip day. We are seniors. Every other year they have a senior skip day. Not this year. It is our right to have a senior skip day. Our right.
What, Matt? Is my GPA not high enough for you to listen to my ideas about senior skip day?
What are your thoughts on the senior prank?
We talked to Ms. Vigno about the whole senior prank situation, and I think that our grade has gotten in enough trouble by itself, so we didn't really want to push ourselves over the edge with that, so we decided to stay out of the senior prank and keep it safe.
Back to the students.
We wanted to let pigs run wild in the school.
That was us.
Can you believe him?
I hear other schools have really funny senior pranks, but I think they have better senior class presidents.
How do you think you did as a class president overall?
I think the officers and I worked really hard over the last 4 years. People may have disagreed with me, but I got elected 4 times in a row, so I'm not going to complain.
What do the seniors have to say about that?
Honestly, he's not really that approachable. Every time I try and talk to him, he rolls his eyes.
Wait, wasn't he our president freshman year?
4 words, no senior skip day.
What do you think about your calls on the snow days?
That's not even my domain, like I don't even deal with
it. I almost died on my drive to school one day because Matt didn't call a snow day.
I can't believe him, only 6 snow days.
Seriously, guys, that's not what I do. I have nothing to do.
Matt just wants to make our lives horrible by making us go to school.
Matt's teachers weigh in.
Oh, Matt Davidson? He's like the worst student I ever had. He never did his work.
Matt Davidson? His lab reports. You know, you would think in honors physics, he would be able to like write down data and like do the calculations and everything. It's like he pooped on the page. It's not even a real lab report. It's terrible.
Yeah. Honestly, Ms. Davidson and I do all the work, and Matt gets all the credit.
All this is fake news.
Matt Davidson, as president, thoughts?
Joel, that's my guy.
That's my guy.
Awful. As vice president, I hate working at the worst. Awful. It brings so much drama throughout our grade. It's amazing, right? I mean, there's a lot. There's been a lot. The egging, probably not. Twitter fights, all that. Just everything about it. Just this math, it's sickening. And I just hope people change. Like, right? Here we are, 10 years later, at our 10-year reunion. A big one out the same, I don't know why. I'm gonna say, that's one crack.
Yeah.
Shouldn't you be over this? That was like 10 years ago now.
No.
Oh. Okay.
Now that Nancy's president, it's more relevant than ever.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
My face. we go.